A Victorian farming community is in shock tonight following the double murder of two brothers. John and Douglas Streeter, both in their 60s, were gunned down in the front yard of their Natty Yallock property, shot in their heads and chests. Douglas's wife Helen found their bodies last night.
You'd never find a bad word about them anywhere, so they just never did anything wrong by anyone.
No weapon was discovered, but police have now found a wallet belonging to one of the brothers in a recycling plant 90 kilometres away. Queensland prosecutors will pursue another 12 outstanding charges against former Bundaberg surgeon Jayant Patel. The decision comes 2 days after a jury cleared Patel of the manslaughter of a patient. He will now stand trial for allegedly killing two other patients and injuring more. Patel's lawyers say they'll have fight for the charges to be dropped.
We're disappointed. We'll make a submission to both the Attorney-General and the DPP.
Patel's next hearing is in a month's time. Tony Abbott says he would move to recognise Indigenous Australians in the Constitution within a year of taking office. Mr Abbott outlined the plan tonight, saying engagement with the Aboriginal community would be a hallmark of his government.
An acknowledgement of Aboriginal people as the first Australians would complete our Constitution rather than change it.
Mr Abbott also says he'll spend a week living and working within a remote Aboriginal community every year. Queensland is the big winner and Western Australia the big loser in proposed changes to GST payments. Adam Todd joins me live now from Canberra. Adam, just how much will Western Australia lose?
Well, Danny, Western Australia is set to miss out on $500 million. Conversely, Queensland is set to receive an extra $700 million. The Commonwealth Grants Commission has released its proposed carve-up of $50 billion in GST revenue. Essentially, the states with stronger economies will have their share cut, while struggling states get a top-up in a bid to direct the money where it's needed. But Western Australia is now getting less GST revenue than the Northern Territory, despite having 10 times the population, and the Premier isn't happy.
It's a complete disregard by the Prime Minister and Treasurer Swan of Western Australia. I mean, it is treating us with disdain as a people.
Some states will lose, some states will win. That is how it has always been.
Now, other states to get a boost are New South Wales and Tasmania, while Victoria and South Australia are said to receive less money than they expected.
Adam Todd in Canberra, thank you. An international high roller has fleeced Crown Casino of $32 million in a high-tech sting. In the Ocean's 11-style operation, it's believed the gambler gained remote access to the casino's security cameras. An accomplice then gave him signals at the table as to how he should bet. A services manager assigned to look after the VIP has reportedly been sacked. Crown is confident most of the loss can be recovered. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 25 degrees in Townsville, 23 in Brisbane, 22 in Sydney, 19 in Melbourne, 20 in Adelaide, and 26 degrees in Perth.